Now, the Minister of Special Projects, S.M. Chandrasena, has presented the view that the executive presidential system should be continued. However, at an event held in Kandy yesterday, it was stated that the executive presidency must be abolished.
A lot of the ministers and MPs who were there when the UNP created this constitution with their 5/6 power are still in parliament today. They have forgotten it today. It is bad when they lose and it is good when they win. We too were opposed to the executive presidency at one time. I know that if not for the executive presidency, we would have never been able to sweep Prabhakaran away from this country. We would have not been able to sweep terrorism away from this country. Although they have been defeated by arms, the ideology has not been removed. The executive should prevail for a long time to come, until peace is properly established in the country, or until democracy is established, until secessionism and the LTT ideology.
As an ordinary individual, I go to the Narahampeta fair to purchase goods for daily needs. When I was there, I met a person from your party who is a good friend. He came close to me and tapped me and said, "Sir, sir, I am the one who is responsible for this problem." But I said, "I am the one who brought this up." But he said, "No, no, I am talking about when you were in power, even though you put forward legal arguments now." I truly felt ashamed. Article 31, Section 2 was removed by the 18th Amendment. It is an accursed amendment. His legal advisers were unaware of this. They thought that it was like Russia, where the disqualification only applies if it is two consecutive terms. The 18th Amendment was introduced before the two terms were up. Look at their cunning. But he did not know that this would come into effect in between. Two consecutive terms. The constitution was then printed anew. This disqualification is not included in it. Why? Because it was removed. No one is aware of this. Since I had all the books, I was aware of it. We have an interpretation ordinance. If a law is removed by an amendment, then the amendment is only effective in the future. If some privilege was obtained under the prevailing law, this will not be removed. This disqualification will not be removed. They did not understand that. It is only now that they are worrying over it.
This president cannot call another presidential election. That is clear. So who wants this to happen? A majority of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party is not for this sudden presidential election. Not only that, even the parties that support the government are not for it. Look at the draft constitutional amendment presented by Athuraliye Ratnathera yesterday. It clearly states that this needs to be reduced, not that an election should be held. Thereby, every political movement in this country, every citizen and organization that shows consideration for democracy and good governance must defeat this measure. The worst thing that could happen to the law in our country is for an individual to take leadership of the country in violation of the constitution. There is a clear unconstitutional problem here. Do not take it lightly.
මෙතන පැහැදිලි විවස්ථා විරෝධී ප්‍රශ්නයක් තිබෙනවා. ඒ ප්‍රශ්නේ සරලව ගන්න එපා.